Hearty welcome to all my dear students. I gladly invite all my dear students to the session 9 of learning the chapter, the demographic structure of the Indian society. In the last class, we were discussing with some points. Among that, the last point was the sample registration system in 2015. This was the last topic in the last class. Today we can learn together about another important topic, that is age structure. First of all, I wanted to give you the meaning of age structure. Age structure means what? The share of people who belong to different age groups, or the portion of people, the parts of people who belong to different age group. This is called age structure. There is a structure of people on the basis of their age, and this is the meaning of age structure. Next point is that in India, the portion of or the share of young people are more. When we make a comparative study of different age group, we can come to the conclusion that in India, the young age population is very high. And next point is, in India, the average age rate is very less. When we make a comparative study between or among the countries, we can come to the conclusion that in India, average age is very less. These are the two important points. Next one, we can make a study on the basis of table 2, which is given in the page number 22. Now I request my dear students to take the page number 22. There we can see a table. The number of the table is 2, table 2, which entitled age composition of the population of India 1961 to 2026. We know that in India there are 10 years, regularly 10 year, what we can say, census is taken. In another way, I wanted to tell you that decennial census is being taken in India. It has been done over the years, and on the basis of the data which is collected out of the census, we can come to some conclusions. This table concludes the data which were taken over the years 1961 to 2026. Why there is 2026? But we have to understand one thing. This is called projection. What do you mean by projection? We can easily take the number which is taken in the year 1961, 1971, 81, because we are getting the real picture of the social statistics. But now we cannot take the data of 2026, because which will come? But we can make some, what we can say, hypothesis. We can make some guessing on the basis of the data which were taken in the past years, what will be in 2026. In the table we can see there are age composition or age groups. Mainly three divisions are there: 0 to 14, 15 to 59, 60 plus years. And this is the division of age groups. Mainly in this way we can divide. And when we closely observe the table, we can see in the first column years are given, second column 0 to 40 years are given. And in 1961 we can see the number of, or the percentage of, actually this is given in percentage, the percentage of people who belong to 0 to 14 is what we can say slightly high. In 71 also, 81 also, a slight variation is there in number. But when we come to 1991, we can see that there is a sharp fall in the number from 41 to 38. There is, it means what? The portion of, the percentage of what we can say people who belong to 0 to 14 years is decreasing from 1961 to 1991. What about the last 3 years, 2001, 11 and 26? We can see in 2001 it was 34 and 2011 it was 29 and 2026 it will be 23. When we compare the percentage between 2001 and 26, we can see there is decrease by 11%. In 2026, there will be decrease in the number of people who belong to 0 to 14 by 11%. It means what? Birth rate will be decreasing in the future. This is all about the 0 to 14 years. Then we can come to 15 to 59 years. We can see 1961, 71, 81, 91, a good number is there. It means what? In our society, the people who belong to 15 to 59 years, their percentage is very high. And what about the last two, 3 years, 2001, 2011 and 26, we can see their number is, percentage is increasing by what we can say 5%. It means what? The difference between 59% and 64%, it is 5%. It means in the future, the number of people who belong to 15 to 59 years will be very high. Then what about next 60 plus years? Now we can make a comparative study over the years. The first four, what we can say, years, it means 61, 71, 81, 91, decennial years, we can see the difference of 10. Decennial years, we can see some slight variations are there. What about last 3 years, 2001, 11, 26? We can see when we compare 2001 and 26, there is increase by 5%. It means what? The people who belongs to who belong to 60 plus years, their percentage will be high in the future. It means what? Life expectancy will increase. Life expectancy means what? This is the what we estimated number of years an average person will live, will survive. It means what? In the future, the people who belong to old age, their number percentage will be high. What about the birth rate? In the future, it will decrease. And middle age group, 15 to what we can say 59, their percentage will be high. And what about life expectancy or old age group? Their number also will be high. Our society will be what we can say including these groups. Their percentage will be very high. Birth rate will be very less in the future. This is all about the page number 22. So we can come to the conclusion that birth rate in the future will decrease. The middle age group, their percentage will be high. It means 15 to 59. Then 60 plus years, their that age group also, we can say, will increase. Their percentage also will increase. This is all about the page number 22. Now we can move to the page number 23, 24 and 25. And in 23, 24 and 25, their details are given on the basis of age group pyramid. Because there is a graphical picture of the age group. This graphical picture will give you more details about age structure in India over the different years. And this is also the statistics or data taken by means of census over the years. It means the decennial years, the difference of 10. Every 10 years we are taking the census. On the basis of that, we can come to the conclusion. So there is a graphical picture of the age group which gives you what detailed study on age group. And on the basis of chart 4, which is a graphical, and we can come to the conclusion on the basis of the chart 4. And first point is that this chart or this age group pyramid will give you details on age structure. This chart will give you detailed information about age structure, because in table 2 we have concentrated on 0 to 14, 15 to 59 and 60 plus. But in the age group pyramid which were taken in 1961, 81, 2001 and 26, we can learn about structure, different structure. It means what? 5 years difference, 0 to 4, 5 to 9. So that by means of age group, we can learn about age structure in a more detailed way. Next point, the pyramid shape. It is in the shape of a pyramid. And the left side, we can see the percentage of males, and right side of the pyramid we can see the percentage of females. And the horizontal bar at either side of the pyramid, we can see the horizontal bar which gives you a visual image of the age structure. It means what? 0 to 4 years there is a horizontal bar. We can see the percentage of people who belong to 0 to 4 years, and there is a horizontal bar is given. And on the basis of that, we can come to the conclusion of the people who belong to 0 to 4 years on the basis of their percentage. Then all these details are taken by means of census. As I told you, and over the years, decennial years, the census are being taken. So we can come to the conclusion by taking the data which are collected by means of census. And next point is the projection. Projection means what? In among the pyramid, we can see the pyramid of graphical structure of age group which will be formed in 2026. And 1961, 1981, 2001, 2026. First three we can easily believe because picture is very much clear. But the last one, India 2026, we can form a graphical structure on the basis of the first three graphical structure. So 26 is formed by depending upon the details which were given in the past years. This is called projection. 26, India 2026 is projection of the age structure which can be formed on the basis of the data which were collected in the past. This is all about the projection. When we study the age group pyramid, we can come to certain conclusions. What are the conclusions? First one is birth rate is decreasing. When we compare 1961 and 81, there is slight variation in birth rate. And what about 2001? 2001 also there is some slight variation, but in 2026 the variation is very high with regard to the birth rate. It means what? The birth rate in the future will decrease. Then what about the middle age group percentage? The middle age group percentage, it means what? 15 to 64, their percentage is very high. It means the working class percentage is very high in India. Next point, this causes the demographic dividend. Demographic dividend means what? The benefit which we are achieving by means of what we can say working class. If the working class percentage is very high in India, it means they are working. If the working class percentage is very high, it will automatically improve our economic development. This is called demographic dividend. Next point, life expectancy in India increases. When we study the pyramid, we can see on the basis of age group over the years, we can see that the number of old people are more. Life expectancy is increasing and the working class people, their number is increasing. So the middle part size is increasing and the top part also increasing, and the bottom part which comprises of the what we can say 0 to 40, their number is decreasing. It means birth rate will be decreasing and middle age group will be increasing, and the top level, that is a old age, that what we can size also will be increasing. It means what? When we look at the pyramid over the years, we can see the bottom level. The bottom level is narrowing, the size is decreasing, and the middle level, that is middle age group, working class group, it is widening, it is becoming wider. And what about the top level? It is also getting wider. It means what? Life expectancy and the demographic dividend can be achieved over the years. This is the conclusion of what we can say the age group pyramid. So in the page number 25, the exercise for chart 4, three questions are given. The first question, where will the 0 to 4 age group of 1961 be located in the pyramid for later years? It means what? As the people are, what we can say, spending their life over the years, it means their age also will be increasing. So the infant will become adolescent. So after some years, the infant will become part of what we can say the middle age group, and middle age group will become part of the old age group. So answer will be middle age group. Then where in which the age group is the widest part of the pyramid as we move from 1961 to 2026? As I already told you that the widest part is middle age group, the working class group, so that it will cause the improvement in economic development. Then third question, what do you think the shape of the pyramid might be in the year 2051 and 3001? So we can make some study on age structure so that we can come to the conclusion, we can make some projection what will be in 2051 and 3001. So we can come to the conclusion that birth rate will decrease, the number of people who belong to middle age group, the size will widen, and old age size of the pyramid also will widen. This is all about the session 9 of learning this chapter. I believe that all my dear students are, what we can say, understanding me, getting me very well. Read the chapter, comprehend the chapter, so that it will give you real picture about our society. So I request all to write some questions. First question, write this one. Study the table 2, study the table 2 and come to the conclusion on the basis of the age structure. Next one, what do you mean by age group pyramid and what are the details given by this? What do you mean by the age group pyramid and what are the details given by this? I might believe that all my dear students are getting me well. Today what we have learned, we learned the meaning of age structure, and in India young people are more, average age is very less. Then on the basis of the table 2 we can learn that birth rate is decreasing, the working class people, their number is increasing, and old people their number is also increasing. The same picture we can learn from the age group pyramid. So life expectancy will be more in India in the recent years, and we can make the projection also, we can also make the prediction on the basis of the data which were collected in the past. This is all about the session 9. Thank you.